Chadwick Moore is a journalist and a frequent guest on the show. He joins us from New York Tonight. So, Chadwick, I know Al Franken pretty well. I've known him for a long time. I've honestly never thought of him as a sexual harasser. I have thought of him a lot as a not a very nice person who, and this is an open secret in Washington, who mistreats his staff. He's a screamer. Mm-hmm. Who takes credit for other people's work. He's basically horrible to those beneath him. And all of that, and I've seen it, has been excused for many years because his politics are mainstream politics here. He's a liberal. And I see this as a theme. Like, if you have the right politics, you get away with kind of whatever you want. You're excused by the left. Am I making that up in my mind?
You certainly aren't making that up in your mind. That is how it is. Look at Hollywood. Look at everything that's happening now. All these allegations that are coming down. And even just aside from basic hypocrisy, right? We have the everyone on the left, especially who's coming after Roy Moore, who's been coming after Roy Moore. Now, you know, when it's their own team, they don't know what to do. This isn't merely hypocrisy. There's something far more sinister, I believe, happening on the left when they've built a party platform that basically tells people like women, like gays, like blacks, that you're victims and we're here to protect you and the other side hates you. And then what happens when people come out, especially in these allegations now? Well, sometimes the women are attacked by the left. You know, Joy Behar famously called Bill Clinton's accusers tramps. So it becomes even more sinister when you realize that they don't care about these people, about these groups that they purport to be standing up for. They only care about one thing, and that one thing is power.
Yeah, accumulating power. I've always thought that the root of all wisdom was knowing how flawed you are. And that's a hedge against self-righteousness. But I've noticed, and particularly in the case of Al Franken, an overweening self-righteousness. I mean, Franken is the first one to stand up in a hearing and lecture people about how he's a lot better than they are. Do you see a connection between outward expressions of self-righteousness and people's secret personal behavior? Am I imagining that too?
I absolutely agree with you. I heard someone say the other day, as soon as you hear a man call himself a feminist, you can start the clock on the rape charges. I believe it was Milo Yiannopoulos who said that. It's absolutely true. The more you're virtue signaling, you see this a lot with race, right? And I've noticed this my entire life. You see this a lot with these sort of white liberal race virtue signalers who are all day long talking about Black Lives Matter, yet they're the first person to cross the street if a black man's walking towards them late at night. They're the first person to be, you know, very rude to their brown-skinned nanny or what have you. It's so obvious that there's some sort of cover going here. When you see someone who's trying so hard to virtue signal that they care for people, these groups of people, well, maybe you should look at that. You know, if
it's
they need
true.
To collectivize people like
it's
that.
True. I once asked Al Sharpton if he was a bigot, and he said to me in a moment of candor, he said, you know, the only group I really don't like, white liberals, because they patronize me. And I thought, that, you know, there's something to this. I'm not a shrink, so I don't fully understand the syndrome here, but it's related. People who have thoughts they're ashamed of tend to attack other people and accuse them of having those thoughts.
Oh, absolutely. I completely agree with you. And that spans the gamut when, you know, people who maybe are a little too puritanical in some things turn out to have the nastiest secrets behind their closet as well, you know?
Yeah. And so I would say Senator Franken is in that category. Chadwick, thank you. That was insightful. I appreciate it.
Great. Thank you.